Try something a little different today. I've been learning the Mirage 2000, so I'm trying the finally feel like I'm getting the hang of it, so I'm trying the included mission Get the Phantoms. Looks like a pretty quick intercept. We'll see how it goes. My flight of four Mirage 2000s from Greece is going to intercept Turkey's Air Force Phantoms are tasked with bombing our main runway. Intel informs that they have fighter cover, and also there is a frigate giving punctual cover near their airbase. Something's lost in translation there. It's all good. Take off and intercept the bombers before they can reach our base. There's a tanker support as naval AA support. Two Perry class frigates. I'm going to stay away from those. Four F4 Phantoms and two F5s as cover. We have a flight of four Mirage. Looks like the alignment's already done. Shut off my lights so that I don't forget to shut them off later. We got our radar in standby mode. We have, let's turn on our ECM systems. Let's assume this is aligned, right? Let's get going here. Weapons in standby mode. Okay, hot start on the runway. Let's move. So, I've owned the Mirage for quite a while. I kind of bought it when it first came out just to say, hey, thanks for making this. But I hadn't actually learned it because it was just, I mean, it was familiar enough. Familiar enough to the American aircraft I'm used to. But just weird enough, so it took me some time to kind of get a handle on it. Of course, if it had an English cockpit, that'd be make the process a little easier for my fellow Americans and whatnot. But that's the one we have. Orbit a little bit, let my flight catch up. But I'm really digging the aircraft. It is just a pleasure. Very capable, very snappy, very responsive. Pretty, I mean, it's more complicated than like the F5, but you know, it's still not too hard to get a handle on once you get over the cockpit being, you know, in French. Radar active. Let's see if we can pick up these friggin' F4s. Been doing some practice missions against some Sukhois, and I've got a really good kill rate against the Sukhoi 27, at least flown by AI. Against a human, who knows, but unfortunately, we only get two of these Super 530s, but pretty capable missile, much more capable than the R20. I'm sorry, the R23ER that the Sukhoi has. If you want to pop them at long range, you can totally do that. They're gonna fire first most of the time, I found. But they're not very accurate, so you can crank. I mean, you can notch them, keep your lock on them, fire pretty high off bore sight. Your Super 530 probably gonna hit. It's pretty accurate. Shut that off for now. Of course, it's not as capable as something like the AMRAAM. But hey, who cares? What is this? Can't seem to get a lock on it. FF isn't pinging him. Maybe I need to get closer. Ah, that's why. That will be our friendly tanker. Let's see what we get. I want to make sure I'm hitting the right button here. Yep, okay. And the INS and the Mirage is definitely takes some getting used to. So that shows distance to steer point. One thing that's helped a lot with this, you know, just with my track IR, this aircraft, for some reason, I keep looking down a lot just because of how the cockpit is. It's built to give you, you know, apparently some really good visibility out here, but the consequence of that is that you have to look down a lot if you want to mess with all the systems. So one thing you can do is adjust your track IR curve, but another thing you can do,
Texaco, on
buy one of these. I love this controller. Logitech G13, and you can see I've got this set up to kind of mimic the PCN. That lets me type and stuff without taking my eyes off the screen. Nothing on radar so far. This is kind of an odd waypoint for them to give me. It's kind of out this, you know, out here. Of course, the intercept is coming this way. Maybe they know the enemy flight plan. Yeah, I'm totally cheating right now.
Okay.
So it looks like waypoint one is more of an IP. That'll be our tanker, it looks like. Sorry, I'm not too energetic this morning. I haven't quite had as much coffee as I normally drink before these little sessions. Let's see if I can fix that. Alright, waypoint one. Under 2 miles away. Looks like that's all the navigation information they give us. So let's head due west. I already am heading due west. Let's turn north a little bit. Kind of northwestish. Let's go about 330 and see what we tend to pick up here. I don't want to get too close to that damn Perry class frigate. When I was a kid, kind of a personal note here, I got to take a tour on a Perry class frigates. That was the USS Flatley, which I think has since been decommissioned, but very impressive. Lots of firepower and something like that. Hey, look, we got an RWR spike. Looks like F4s. About 11 o'clock. All right, a little fence check here. Okay, weapons on. 530 selected. Fuel state got a lot. Let's dump that. Make sure I'm on air-to-air fly-by-wire mode. Okay. Put that on crossfeed. Alright, contact. What are you? You look like bad guys. Like you're about to get a Super 530 in the face. That is an F4. It won't stay locked for some reason.
On spike, 11 o'clock. On spike, 11 o'clock.
Yeah, that's that frigate. Alright, I'm gonna wait for them to come to me. I do not want to get close to that dam. What's that? Some ECM, it looks like. That's probably why I can't lock onto it. Speaking of ECM, broiler. I wonder why my IFF system isn't working. Did I forget something here? That'll do it. Gotta turn it on first. How about that shit? one's a friend. These F4s doing. Swing the radar back around on them. See if I get a good picture here. I really don't want to get close to that damn frigate. That's gonna be a bad day. Can't seem to maintain a lock though, I don't know exactly why. There we go. Alright, let's engage. This is gonna get messy. In range. I want to make sure of a hit, so I'm going to wait until we get in probability range. Missile queued up. And that looks good. Eat shit. Splash one. Okay, let's get the fight to break. One.
Two. Tally bandit, 11 o'clock.
Splash two. Cue the magics.
Two. Tally bandit, 11 o'clock.
Flight. Engage bandits.
Let's cheat a little bit, huh? Well, that looks pretty good to my eye. What's up with this? Did we scare him off? Yeah. Okay, so it looks like we splashed two F5s and two F4s. The The other two F4s went back to base for some reason. Let's have them. Cover me.
Flight. Cover me.
3. Copy. 4. Copy.
No. Wondering if I should go back and rearm and load up on Super 530s or just engage those two F4s, assuming they come down to meet us. Wonder if I should go hit him with the magic missile. Let's see. What's he doing? Screw it. Fortune favors the bold. Let's go nail them when they take off, huh? Yeah. It could create a new waypoint on Novorossiysk, but yeah, maybe I'll do that just to kind of get some practice in. I'm gonna go over land to hopefully stay out of range of that damn frigate. Let's see. Engage autopilot. Let's get some coordinates. Looks like 4441. 44-41-15 north. Did I get that right? 44-41-15. No. 44, I guess it doesn't really matter. 44, 41, that'll get us close enough. And then, so 44, 49, let's redo that. Bye. 46, 44, no, 37, 46, 44, 37, 46, 44. Damn it. So we've created waypoint 2. Let's set that as our active. Autopilot off, and let's fly to Novorossiysk.
Bingo fuel.
Bingo fuel. Well, that would change things, won't it? That F4 looks ripe for strafing. I wonder if he got hit or something in an RTB'd. Anyway, let's engage autopilot and compress time a little bit, because I don't want to wait. Hello, frigate.
Two, on spike, 10 o'clock.
And let's go to cannon mode, shall we? This is not the best way to do this, but I think it's all we got going on right now. First we have to find the F4, and then we can kill the F4. not seeing it. Because it's the wrong airbase. Let's keep going this way. There we go. I'll find you yet, buddy. I see you now. This is what happens when you learn DCS in the A-10 and then switch to the Mirage. Strafe all the things. Gun sight. What's up with that? I don't know. I haven't actually learned air to ground modes, so I'm gonna have to guesstimate. Or we could try this. Oh, that doesn't look good. Signature? Nope. That was sloppy as hell. Get just a fixed gun cross, that's what I need. Gotta be a way to do it here. Maybe the fly-by-wire system.
Three, RTB.
Probably in the same condition myself.
Three, copy.
Let's empty the gun and head back home. And there's a problem in DCS with the damage model as far as damage modeling. When you attack aircraft on... yeah, hang on, let me strafe this and try to strafe it at least, and then we'll talk about that on the way back. That's all I got. So I got some strikes on it, but it didn't die. Alright, let's go back. Alright, so damage modeling. That's prep. Desk button doesn't work. There we go. Let's get away from that frigate.
Two, sand launch, 2 o'clock.
Hello? Launch the countermeasures.
Launch spike, 2 o'clock.
Countermeasures. Hello? Launch them. They're not launching. I'm gonna have to rely on this mountain to not get my ass shot. Ugh.
Two, engage defensive. Two, sand launch, 3 o'clock.
Looks like he went to go play with the frigate for some reason. He's probably gonna get his ass dead.
Flight RTB.
Let's create waypoint 4 at the home plate. Sochi, right? 432647. Bye. 395555. Oops. Zero. Okay, and now let's navigate to 4. That should give us a cue up here. Should. Overwrote waypoint 2 for some reason. Whatever. Works for me. Alright, so let's talk about damage modeling. This has been done to death. Yeah, so if you hit a tank with a missile, it usually blows up and it dies. If you hit an airplane in the air, usually it'll blow off a wing and it'll fall to the ground and it dies, or it'll just explode right away. If it doesn't explode right away, it will register as a death when it strikes the ground. The problem is, if you do marginal damage like that, which is not an instant kill, and then the airplane makes a soft landing or is on the ground already and it's not like fully blown apart entirely, it never registers as dead. So like that F4, we hit it, if it was flying, that would have knocked it out of the sky, but since it was on the ground, it didn't really seem to do a whole lot to it. So it's not going to register as a kill. It's still back there on the runway. See, DCS still shows that it's just fine and dandy. They're working on it. Everything is subject to change. Let's compress time a little bit. I don't have a whole lot else to say at the moment. Watch my fuel state dwindle. Should have enough to make it 55 miles. He ejected, probably ran out of fuel. Way to go, guy. I am running pretty low.
Sushi, Springfield, 1-1, inbound.
Hey, look, there's the waypoint I created. We have some misalignment, but I'm really digging the Mirage. Excellent work from Razbam for sure. And what I really can't wait for is the Harrier. I'm kind of excited to see what they have in store for us there. You can just feel the just enormous amounts of lift from this huge wing. It's kind of nice. You can just float. Did they ever clear me for landing? I don't even care anymore. Trying to adjust my slope with the throttle here. And flare. Shut the throttle back. Speed brakes. Keep the nose up to air brake the aircraft and thump. Brakes on. Nose with steering on. And we have landed. Hopefully that's a mission complete. Let's see what happens.
Taxi to parking area.
Probably not, because I think that that F4 probably needed to die. Let's just quit here. I want to see what happened. So yeah, see it. That sucks. I don't know why that guy RTB'd. Let's see what happened. Okay, so it took off. Figure I orbit around here because I didn't know what that bubble looked like. So it looks like four came out to meet us. He drops his payload here. See, that's, we defended the airbase. That's a mission success, in my opinion. Then lined up on one of the F5s and BVR his ass. Smack. And at that point, I gave the order for my wingmen to engage. Looks like they ditched their bombs. See, that's a mission kill, you know? That they don't get to do what they came here to do. We win. Everybody's happy, except for them. Nailed them. This looks like it's probably going to be a magic shot from this guy here. Or maybe cannon, let's see. Smack. Look, I hit this F4 with 25 plus 55, so that's 50, 60, 100 rounds from the 30mm cannon. Here's my gun runs. They don't kill it. Fly home and land. Yeah, it's just a quick and easy mission, I guess. Still fun. I got to blow two things up. And it sounds like it's time for me to go. So I hope you enjoy this. And nothing too in-depth, just some fun. Good hunting out there.